simple tips. Tip 1. If your kids buy at the cafeteria every single day, that takes about $100 out of your parents' account every single month. But then, if you do that times 1 year, that equals $1,200. So much money! You can buy a watch, a phone, or a computer with that money. If your school gives out extras like a goldfish, apple juice, or fruit roll-ups, and you do buy it every single day, that's about $40 a month. And if that's times 1 year, that equals about $480. So much money you could buy. Not anything, but a lot of things with that money. So, tip 2 is reuse stuff. Like, reuse paper. Like this paper. Kumon paper, right? And then I use it for my homework because it has a blank side and I have enough space for it. Instead of buying over and over so many ruled books like this over here, you can use scrap paper that you already have. And then you're not wasting trees also and breaking our environment. And now, to save crayons or reuse crayons, you don't need to buy a 64 crayon pack every single year for your school. Instead, you can use your old crayons and then melt it down and then wait until it hardens and then take it out. Ta-da! New crayons! Last for tip 2 is reuse cloth. You can use torn clothes or torn anything that's like clothes, anything that's clothes. And then once you cut it into something, anything you can cut it into, you can like wet it and then clean up all the messes that you do for your science experiments, paintings, and a lot of stuff, like the counter if you have chores like that. Tip 3. Use secondhand stuff, like secondhand toys. I use my secondhand fraction puzzle or toys, like that. I get to use a secondhand bike. You're saving a lot of money in that. Even a secondhand scooter, instead of buying a brand new one, you're saving money. Or you can use secondhand clothes, like I use my secondhand ski gear or rain gear, like that, or winter gear. For books, you can go to the library, borrow it. Go to the library, borrow books like Harry Potter, Tintin, Nate the Great. Any books you can borrow from the library. Or if you want your own book, you can go to the library sale shop. Then you can, like, get books just for a few cents. Or you can go to the secondhand bookstore. That's just a few dollars also. Tip 4. Ask your grandparents, aunts, uncle, anybody that's related to you, or anybody that's going to bring you a present. Well, actually, aunts and uncles and your relatives is better. But ask them, instead of buying a toy, ask them to give you the money for the toy. Instead of buying the toy, because you'll get bored of it, or some of them you don't like, that's rude to say to them. Or they break, obviously. But money never breaks. Shameful for that part. Thank you folks for watching video number 2. Video number 3 is coming less than a week, and it's about history of money, so you can learn all about money. Please like the video, please share it, and please press the bell and the subscribe button. Thanks for watching my video, and bye!